Hey, this is Kurt the Boat Doctor. Out here in this nice, beautiful 235 Pacific Nav, sliding windows, rear little window you can look out, net holders, grab handles, gold wing door. Got a nice Garmin in here. I set that up. It's going to the lake, so I didn't really fine tune it. Bow mount works great. You got your foot feet. Plus you got your wireless remote. Now I can say the battery charger's there. The batteries are in there. I think I showed you all that stuff already. So I'll just show you the running of it first. So let's get started with the main motor. We just fire that up. Since we got everything kind of in there, that's that slope curtain too. And then I showed you all the lights, I believe, courtesy lights. Half deck light. This is starting up, so I'll wait. USB port, you know they're working, it's blue. And stereo, we'll just hit this real quick.
Real nice. Change your watch battery while you shop.
Then you go to your sources, AM, FM, you just dial through that. You go back, I just bring you back. Very simple search. Brightness. On that trim. I'm going to trim it down all the way.
Legendary
used eco and flow voltmeter, and you can go into these, and if you hold that, you can go into replace data mode, battery voltage here, and then we want the digital. See how I'll put the digital numbers right there? See, radio works good. Turn that down just a bit. You get better reception over here. And like you say, the wipers, port, starboard port. Then it gets up to, it's about 45, 46 mile an hour boat. They need to bleed the steering. Hit it, ready, 1,000, whoa! Man, 2 seconds to bleed this bad boy. Then if you go right here about 28 miles, you're using 6.9 gallons, that's pretty good. Wide open, trimmed up. I'm gonna start trimming it. 45, 6, 46, 47. About 47 miles an hour, and it gets it. Goes right over this. It's starting to rain, evidently, huh? So that's that motor, just trim her on down. And then if you go over here, you can get into your trip information. And then no, back, boat settings, I already did that, device settings, you can change your color and stuff like that. So we're gonna just shut this thing off now. So we showed you the stereo, so we're just gonna push this and shut that baby off. Okay, then we're gonna fire up the Garmin. We're just gonna hit that, it's got tilt wheel as well. So we showed you that. So that's warming up. What we're gonna do is go back here. Then we're just gonna hit this down here. And I don't know if I showed you this already, but hit this here. That's your aerator live well. That's on this dial here. You can hear it when you fill it up. You wanna plug that back there. This valve here is to shut the water off, so if you don't put the cap on it, you're going down the water, it's going to shoot water in here, or you can shut this valve off. You turn that on, I just put that in there. There's your work down, put that back again, turn that off. So when it's cold, you want to pull this out and put this in gear like this and give it like 7 pumps and bring it back, put it in neutral, but raise this thing up to about here. But now once it's warm, you can just leave that in, but raise this here, bring that back. So then we're gonna put that in gear. So you can run this as a tiller right now, but once you engage the autopilot, you wanna make sure you lift that back because it could end up jamming up back here. So hit agree. And now I've put a combo up here. Now where you're at, you may get a little bit more of the lake detail. So what I'm going to do is go ahead, like right here, later, because we already did it, so we don't have to do that. Okay, so you can hit this, go into here if you're in that, and then you can go engage heading hold. Oh, it's got to regain the speed source. That's right, heading hold, there you go. So there you go, we're starting to hold the heading. Now speed, you can just hit there. Now say I want to do a U-turn. I can go pattern steering, U-turn, engage port. Now while I'm doing that, I can hit that menu button again. Navigation options, go back, autopilot. Now I'm in a U-turn right now, right? So now say I don't want to complete that U-turn. I just want to get maybe a nice turn without hitting 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. I can just do a U-turn or a circle and get me headed where I want, and then just hit engage heading hold. See, then it will hold me there instead of having to get out of that. Now I'll let this thing pick up some speed. And that will bring it back over here. Speed source fault. Yeah, heading hold. There you go. You're going to get that once in a while because you don't really have any. I could run off the. You know what? I might turn that into GPS speed. What I might do. Okay, we're going here, so I can now on this screen I can go 10 over or 1 over, but I'm going to go into here real quick. Autopilot setup, preferred sources. I'm going to go just there. Okay, because we don't care about that. Wizard, dockside wizard. Welcome to begin. Yes, switch check. Next, GPS. So we're gonna use GPS as a source. So then that won't say no speed source, okay? See how it said that there? Because now we gotta make sure we're getting GPS signal. Because if you don't, because you didn't have a GPS antenna, it may be looking for the GPS speed. See, speed source alert. Yeah, see how I'm not getting any speed up here? That's why it's doing that. This has got, you're going off the built-in one, and it should have probably went to an external antenna, but Garmin's are pretty good. But if that ever says speed source, first thing you do is go back to your data, or go back to your, like right into here, go into charts, go to charts here. If you don't get any of those readings right there, that means it's loading satellites, and you'll see a little question mark flashing in there. That means you'll get that speed source problem. Now get back, then we go back into combos, go to combo over here, go in, that's depth finder right here. And now I'm looking for my speed. There's foot. Okay, see how the feet right there, it ain't reading. You got to enable the sonar, then close. And the Fahrenheit, so I still don't have my speed coming up here, but what I'm going to do is hit this real quick, go to my options, sonar setup, appearance, go into that, fine scope, color gain, let's go back, sonar setup, appearance, advance, what I was going to try to do is find some numbers real quick for you. See, I'm still not getting any bearing up there. So now I'm just hitting 10 over. See how it went to 317? One would drop it 1 degree. And well, that thing's loading. But you know what? I'm going to go back into here real quick, go to sonar. Just sonar only. Degrees, boom, boom, boom. Some reason, range, transmit, gain, beam width, sonars, overlays, right here, data, sidebar, back. Yeah, okay. So I'm right. You don't need the speed here if you got it over here. So anyway, 10 over again. I'm all over the map. This always happens to me. Okay, so now, say I wanted to plan a route. I can go ahead and go to charts, nav charts. Now say I want to go right over here where I started. Whoa, to go right there. I just tap that, hit auto guidance, start navigation, and then pretty soon it's going to say, do you want to engage autopilot? But then, of course, it probably ain't going to do it because I don't have navigation yet. That's the whole kickback now, is that I don't have any of my GPS running right now, so it's just going to take a while to hook up to that C speed source heading hold. So anyway, I'll try to get some GPS signal and do this again. So I can stop navigation right here, just stop it. You can also, I'll show you how you can follow your route and stuff. I'm going to get over here where I know I got better satellite reception. Now, standby, you can hit here and put it on standby. Now, that's kicking it off. But what we can do also is just hit this again. We can go to combos. We can go to this one. And then we can go ahead and hit this one real quick. Options. And engage heading hold. You always have to do that. U-turn. Speed it up. Again, remember? Okay, so we got that.